Good morning class 6, today we will start second chapter components of food. As you can see in this chapter, let's some reading. In chapter 1, we made list of the food items that we eat. We also identified food items eaten in different parts of India and marked these on its app. A meal could consist of chapati, dal and brinjal curry. Another may be rice, sambar and a vegetable. Preparation of lady's finger, bhindi. At another meal could be opam, fish curry and vegetables. This is activity in this. Region or state has been shown like Punjab. Item of grain is makki. Makki is a corn, roti. In Andhra Pradesh, that is rice. For makki, item of dal meat is rajma. Rajma is also known as kidney beans. And along with rice, there is tuar dal, arhar dal. And vegetables, sarso saag in Punjab, mustard leaf curry, sarso saag. And curd and ghee in Andhra, kunduru. And buttermilk, ghee, pickle. All these things has been shown, so you should make this table in your copy. Let's read this paragraph. Curds, buttermilk and pickles, some examples of meals from different regions are given in table 2.1. So this is table 2.1. Select food items you depicted in the map and some more meals to this list and enter these in table 2.1. Sometimes we may not really have all this variety in our meals. If we are traveling, we may eat whatever is available on the way. Along the journey, you have to take another things like samosa or tea or sandwich. But you cannot have all these things. So, you should be well aware about what is needed to our balanced diet or balanced growth of our body and brain. There must be some reason to why meals usually consist of such a distribution. So do you think that our body needs different kinds of food for some special purpose? So what do different food items contain? We know that each dish is usually made up of one or more ingredients which we get from plants or animals. Let's go for another chapter. Ingredients contain some components that are needed by our body. These components are called nutrients. The major nutrients in our food are named carbohydrates, proteins, fish, vitamins and minerals. These are very important. The major nutrients in our food are carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. Very important. You should learn and note. In addition, food contains dietary fibers and water which are also needed by our body. Do all foods contain all these nutrients? No. All foods cannot contain all these nutrients. Some foods may contain protein more, some may contain carbohydrate more, some may contain minerals more, some may contain water more, some may contain dietary fiber more. So with some simple methods, we can test whether cooked food or a raw ingredient contains one or more of these nutrients. The test for presence of carbohydrate, protein and fats are simple to do. Means we can check in a food whether carbohydrate or starch or protein is present or not. Let's do test and record all your observation. So for carrying out these tests, you will need solution of iodine. If there is iodine solution, we can check copper sulfate and caustic soda. You will also need a few test tubes and a dropper. So this activity can be performed in chemistry lab. Because these items we did not have at our home, so we could not test these things. So we will learn and study only these things. It means that we can check whether there is starch or carbohydrate or protein in any food item. Try this test on cooked food items as well as raw materials. Raw means which are not cooked. Table 2.2 is where. This is table 2.2. In this table, we can find that स्टार्च इज प्रेजेंट और नॉट, प्रोटीन इज प्रेजेंट और नॉट, फैट इज प्रेजेंट और नॉट. सो दिस एक्टिविटी कैन बी डन एट लेबोरेटरी ओनली और इन स्कूल व्हेन स्कूल ओपन्स. सो डोंट बोदर. If the required solutions are not available in ready-made form, your teacher can prepare them as well. So let's begin by testing different food items to see if they contain carbohydrate. So there are many types of carbohydrate. The main carbohydrate found in our food are in the form of starch and sugars. Starch and sugars are like carbohydrate. We can easily test if food items contains starch. So this is activity for test for starch. Take a small quantity of food item or a raw ingredient, put 2-3 drops of dilute iodine solution on it. Observe if there is any change in the color of the food item. Did it turn blue black? If it becomes blue black, color indicates that it contains starch. So this is the test for starch. Repeat this test with other food items and find out which of these contains starch. Enter all your observation in table 2.2. Let's go for test for protein. Take a small quantity of food testing. If the food you want to test is a solid, you first need to make a paste of it or powder it. Grind or mash a small quantity of the food item. Put some of this in a clean test tube and 10 drops of water to it and shake the test tube. Now using a dropper, add 2 drops of solution of copper sulfate and then 10 drops of solution of caustic soda. Means you should have copper sulfate and caustic soda. These are found in chemistry lab, not at home. So shake well and let the test tube stand for a few minutes. What do you observe? Did the content of the test tube turn violet? A violet color indicates presence of protein in the food item. Now you can repeat this test on another food item. So for today, this is sufficient. You can read it again and again. At least you should watch this video and listen carefully twice and thrice. Thank you.